Hello, my name is Roland Enns, and I'll be your host for this month's issue of Eye on California's Economy. This month's issue will feature the Port of Oakland. The Port of Oakland consists of the Deepwater Port of Oakland, the Oakland International Airport, and 20 miles of commercial property located in the San Francisco Bay. 400 miles south of us is the ports of Long Beach and Los Angeles. Long Beach, Los Angeles, and the Port of Oakland makes up 50% of the container freight that travels in and out of the United States. I chose this month's topic in response to the gridlock of the nation's ports, primarily the Port of Long Beach and Los Angeles. The grounding of the container ship Ever Given on March 23rd in the Suez Canal and the backlog that it created has emphasized the fragility of the vital movement of goods and services that the planet's population depends on. Long Beach and Los Angeles has more than 100 ships that lay at anchor each day. The system is broken, but wait. The Biden-Harris administration has waded in on the issue by requiring the port to operate 24/7. With this brilliant proclamation, it clearly shows how little they know how all of the parts of the system work. The problem is only fixable if all of the parts function together in a uniform manner. Government, whether federal, state, or local, doesn't have, nor for the most part, do they have the ability or vision to come together to create a system that works cohesively throughout the nation. We certainly don't have it in California. There's no vision and certainly no leadership. We vote people in and out of office, for the most part, people that have a self-serving agenda. I'll say it again, no vision and no leadership from county government, city government, or the state capital. California is the fifth or sixth largest economy in the world. California needs to be run as a business with a governor that knows how to communicate with international, federal, and state governments. I'm going to save this topic for another issue. But think about it. We are one of the major economies in the world. Our state is not represented on the world's business stage with competent state leadership. Now this brings up the state's current problem with the nation's supply chain. On October 29th, 2021, the Port of Oakland sent out a press release. It is shown on the screen. I'll share the first two paragraphs with you. The Port of Oakland officials today called on shipping lines to route more cargo here amidst supply chain calamities elsewhere. The port said that its marine terminals are congestion-free. Unlike competing ports crippled by record global trade volumes, it has urged restoration of shipping services that have bypassed Oakland since the summer. There is no congestion at the Oakland seaport, and we're ready for more business, declared Port of Oakland Maritime Director Brian Brandes. We need ocean carriers to reinstate services in order to stabilize the supply chain, and our import and export partners echo this sentiment. The Port of Oakland loads and discharges more than 99% of the containerized freight moving through Northern California. Oakland's cargo volume makes it the eighth busiest container port in the United States based on calendar year 2020. San Francisco Bay ranks among the four largest Pacific Coast ports for containerized cargo, along with Los Angeles, Long Beach, Seattle, Tacoma, and Washington State. In 2020, about 76% of Oakland's trade was with Asia. Europe accounted for 14%, Australia and New Zealand about 3%. Other nations about 2%. About 5% of Oakland's trade is domestic, principally Hawaii. California's three major container ports carry approximately half of the nation's total container volume. The Port of Oakland is serviced by BNSF Rail. All major highways converge into the Bay Area, 880, 680, and 580, and to the east, Interstate 5. The Port of Oakland is uniquely situated geographically in the state for future growth into the next century. 60 miles east is the area occupied by the cities of Lathrop, Manteca, and Tracy. The region is fast becoming the West Coast hub for fulfillment and warehousing. This is primarily known as the Tracy Triangle. For more of the Tracy Triangle, please see our issue on California's economy, the Tracy Triangle. Both Union Pacific and BNSF have rail yards for intermodal shipment of goods. The area is serviced by trucks utilizing Highway 5, 580, and the 205. Future growth is attainable with the abundance of available land and resources. At one time, there was a movement to put together a dedicated rail link directly from the Port of Oakland to the Tracy Triangle area. Lack of vision killed the project, and the lack of vision put more trucks onto the main corridor servicing San Francisco and the greater Bay Area with the valley. It is not uncommon for commuters traveling over the Altamont Pass to experience 4, 5, and even 6 hours a day in traveling into and out of the greater San Francisco area. Now we see gridlock up and down 99 as it passes through town after town. My only hope that in future elections we can look past party differences, put aside the talking heads spreading contempt and hatred, legitimizing lies and ignorance. Eliminate the self-serving so we can focus on the future, so we can close our eyes someday and look fondly on what we can create for the future. I on California's economy encourages you to become engaged with those that are supposed to represent you and the public. If you like this content, please hit like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Welcome back, and now it's time for news briefs. The ENS USA California Stock Performance Index stock figures at the close of September stands at 21%, 2 percentage points higher than the previous month. Keep in mind that these figures are based on the stock's opening figure as of January 1, 2021. These figures indicate the strength of California's economy. There is no reference or indication that this program endorses the purchase of any stock listed in the index or discussed in any of its programming. The California Stock Performance Index consists of 29 stocks domiciled in California. This month, there's a new name on the list. Facebook has changed its name to Meta Platforms. At this time, the stock symbol, FB, remains the same. The outstanding performers this year to date are Williams-Sonoma at 82%, Wells Fargo 70%, Alphabet at 69%, Tesla at 58%, eBay at 53%, and Live National Entertainment at 38%. For some reason, Live National Entertainment did not show up on my six-pack list. The California unemployment figures continue to improve. At the close of August, the unemployment rate stood at 7.5%, a continued improvement over the previous months. The counties of Imperial, Kern, and Tulare showed rates higher than 10%. Los Angeles is now below 10%, indicating 9.5% unemployment. I see a typo in San Diego's unemployment figures. Those out of work are 101,700 and not 1,001,700. The rate is correct at 6.6%. Thank you for watching. Please hit the like and subscribe button. If you have a comment or if you wish to provide content, please email me. Thank you again and have a wonderful month.